Hello to everyone. You can save money by increasing your 10 milliliters liquid culture to 350 milliliters or even more. If you're wondering how this is done, I suggest you watch the whole video. With this method, we'll have enough liquid cultures to experiment a lot, and we will save money. Let's get started. For this process, we need 300 milliliters of hot water, a jar, a lid with a filter and an injection port, a powder or liquid main culture additive, a glass ball or a magnetic stir bar, 10 milliliters of liquid culture, alcohol cleaning wipes and a sterile needle. This process will take about 20-25 days. And after about 25 days, we will have obtained 350 milliliters of liquid culture. We can inoculate 1 kilogram of grain with a 10 milliliter syringe. We will be able to produce up to 35 kilograms of seeds with 350 milliliters of liquid culture. With 35 kilograms of seeds, we can prepare 1,000 kilograms of substrate. Here, we used concentrated liquid additive prepared for 350 milliliters. However, you can also use powder additives. I will show the formula of the powder additive on the screen. We put the magnetic stirrer in your jar and pour 300 milliliters of hot water. We thoroughly wipe the inside of our lid with an alcohol cleaning wipe and close the lid. We need to cover it with aluminum foil, so that water does not come to the filter of our lid. I put a metal plate at the bottom of the pot, and pour about 500 milliliters of water. After placing the jar in the pot, I close the lid and bring the pressure settings to the highest level. I will keep it at high level until the steam comes out. After the steam burst, I will lower the heat and sterilize for a full 30 minutes. In this way, we will autoclave the jar in its liquid. After 30 minutes, we will take our pot from the stove and wait for it to cool down by itself for one night. During this time, we will definitely not open the lid. One day passed, and I took the jar out. I will use mask and gloves today for hygiene reasons. Even our breath can carry airborne mold spores and bacteria to the metal tip of our needle. That's why we have to be careful. I clean all materials with isopropyl alcohol. Specifically, I thoroughly wipe the lid and injection port with alcohol. Now, I will carefully take the sterile needle out of its pouch, and the cap on the head of the syringe. I squeeze all the liquid. If you want, you can squeeze less for your later uses or to get a backup. I use all of them to save time. I clean the injection port again after removing the needle. That was the transaction. The liquid in the jar may appear blurry in the first days due to the caramelized sugar. However, as the hyphae grow, the fluid will become clear and the hyphae will begin to appear clear. For 20 days, I will stir the jar for 1-2 minutes every day. Today is the 6th day. It has taken up about a third of our jar. And looks healthy. Let's see the jar again in a few days. Today is the 15th day. More than half of the jar has formed mycelium. The upper part of the liquid is very clear. This shows that our culture is healthy. Now we can use it whenever we want by sucking a syringe from it. Before use, let's shake the jar like this. Yes, friends, we will save money by getting about 35 syringes with this technique. So what do you think about it? Please write in the comments. I hope you liked our video. If you like it, click the like button and subscribe. You can also support us by sharing this video with your friends. Thank you for watching us. See you again in our next video. Bye.